Jeanne. They were Hollywood's most beloved couple. All show business grieved when they divorced in 1969, but their bond never died. When Dean's health shattered, Jeanne stayed at his bedside. When Dino Jr.'s plane crashed, they wept in each other's arms. Their love survived divorce, booze, and tragedy. Dean and Jeanne, Hollywood's greatest love story. Jay Bernstein, Hollywood super agent. He's been in the superstar galaxy with some of the biggest names and faces of Hollywood. And boy, oh boy, brace yourself, West Coast. Some of his inside stories will shake you more than the last quake. And Jillian, she's one beautiful lady, and she's gracing both the big and small screen in an upcoming movie and a brand new television series. She's on top of the world and couldn't be happier. Hello, everyone. I'm Ari Povich, and welcome to a special Thanksgiving edition of A Current Affair. Our Cindy Adams has been out on the West Coast all week as our special Hollywood host, and she joins us now, and one of the big surprises is Cindy hasn't been kicked out of there yet. Cindy?
Thank you, Maury. I think in 1968, Barbara Streisand made Hello, Dolly right here, right in this place. And I am the very, very first size 7.5 AA to set foot on this set in 21 years. Naturally, I myself barely remember the movie. It was way before my time, more than your time, Maury. But I love this town. You may be interested in knowing that this is a town where every single person carries a card in his wallet that says, in case of accident, notify my press agent. Maury Love, since I don't mind having you on my show, is there anything else you might like to say?
Oh, well, we've got a terrific Thanksgiving show tonight, Cindy. As you know, you're much more than just a little part of it. You're a big part of it. And we're going to be back with Dean and Jeanne Martin, Hollywood's greatest love story, after this.
Think of our show, A Current Affair.
What?
No, okay.
A Current Affair.
You seem to always be there. That's right. That's good.
Always on top of the news.
Always on top of things. A Current Affair.
Well, you wouldn't think so, but one of Hollywood's legendary love affairs is that of Dean and Jeanne Martin. Dean and his lady have been primetime partners lifetime in love and have weathered professional setbacks and personal tragedies, even after their marriage officially dissolved many years ago. Our reporter Gordon Elliott and producer Audrey Lavin tell us about the couple whose love will last forever.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
After a lifetime of standing ovations, Dean Martin won a heartfelt applause greater than any he had collected before.
And, you know, Jeanne came with me. We're kind of getting together again.
It was clear this was no ordinary love story. It began as publicly as any of Dean's jokes, songs, or movies. My Jeanne, Dean would call her during every show. Dean's Jeanne. We never saw her, but Dean loved her, so we loved her too. 40 years ago they met, 20 years ago they divorced, yet today they are closer than ever, and friends say that they wouldn't be surprised to find a wedding invitation in the mail.
They care about one another. They always did. They were divorced for a long time, and they realized that they really needed one another.
Jeanne was rarely in the public eye, yet we have heard of her care and devotion every time Dean climbed on stage. The petite blonde Mrs. Martin became a picture in our mind's eye of a remarkable woman.
She's got a twinkle in her eye that he sees, and he remembers that when they were both very young, a long, long time ago.
And wouldn't you rather say, I love you?
Through the years, Jeanne would see her clown prince flail, stumble, and soar into booze, drugs, and self-pity. She was always there to throw an arm around him and drag him back to his feet.
Dean, some years ago, almost died. You know, he got hooked on Percodan, And, of course, he was boozing and everything. So a bunch of his friends, like Greg Garrison, who produced all his TV shows, they just put him in a room at Cedars at Sinai and threw the key away. And of all the girls that Dean had been with over the years, the only one that came to help was Jeanne. And they, ever since that, they've been very, very close.
And it was the closeness between Dean and Jeanne that carried them through the grim search and recovery of the body of their 32-year-old son, Dean Paul, whose Air Force jet crashed into a California mountain in 1987.
It was a terrible shock to him. It really was. And, of course, even more so to Jeanne, you know, who was, but naturally he's getting over, you know, life has to go on, you know, you have to work, and you have to, it's very hard to be a clown, you know, when something like that happens, you have to go out and make people laugh.
But because of Jeanne, Dean hit the stage running 6 months later. She convinced him to resume his 3 to 4 week Las Vegas obligations. Through the heartache, Dean and Jeanne fell in love all over again. And almost at the same time, the film Moonstruck made a brand new hit out of a tune Dean recorded more than 30 years ago. The first time they fell in love.
When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool at the more.
And as Dean's Rat Pack buddy Frank Sinatra would say, love is lovelier the second time around. 20 years ago, the pack stepped in and snatched Dean away for a while. Jeanne was discarded in a new wild life of wine, women, and song.
Dean used to drink pretty well. Yeah, he drank pretty well, although I think Sinatra spills more than Dean drinks.
Well, that's about it, except I'd like to thank all you on the dais for your friendship, and I want you to know I'll remember this night until I get to my car.
But no matter how many times he had one too many, Dean could always count on Jeannie's help to steer him home. In fact, Jeanne has always been part wife, part den mother, especially when she helped Dean cope with the breakup of his other great marriage.
Oh, there we are again, Jerry Lewis.
Yes, here we are, Dean Martin. I'm going to introduce your song, Max, So Fly Away.
Max, So Fly Away? I don't get this.
Well, your name is really Dean, but I called you Max, and I told you to fly away because Max Fly is the name of a golf ball, and the sponsor doesn't want us to make any plugs.
We need the golf ball,
because
too.
We both play golf, so send them to the house right away.
Another friendship crisis Dean survived with Jeanne's help was the revived Rat Pack tour last year when Frank and Sam went on tour without him.
I think they may have had a little falling out in this tour. Dean is a typical Las Vegas singer, but Dean's style does not lend itself to a baseball stadium.
But some say he dropped out of the tour because he just didn't want to work anymore. He is a very wealthy man.
Dean is the largest stockholder, individual, private stockholder of RCA stock.
A frugal Dean married money burner Kathy Horn in 1973 after handing Jeanne a $40 million divorce settlement. The wedding took place at the Beverly Hills Hotel, a hotel so close to Jeannie's home, she could almost hear the music.
She was a very beautiful girl, very attractive, but she had a black belt in shopping.
Soon after they married, Jeanne watched the man she stood by for 30 years hand over half his fortune to the former receptionist in a mega divorce settlement. Meanwhile, Jeanne, a former Miami Beach beauty queen, was dating a guy named Frank Calcagini. But that didn't last too long before she was back at Dean's side.
I know Jeanne loves him. She always talked about Dean. She always talked about him, Even when they were separated, divorced.
Dean's life has slowed down in recent years. He rents a home in the flats of Beverly Hills, just a few blocks away from Jeanne's home. He plays often on his favorite golf course and has quiet dinners with Jeanne at their favorite restaurant in Beverly Hills. He rarely goes out.
Dean watches a lot of television. He's a very knowledgeable. You know, he could do the reviews for the soap operas every day.
If he does wander out, he'll come home early. Home to his best friend, his inspiration, the woman he met on the Orange Bowl float in 1949, my Jeanne.
And I guess he still sees that little marvelous twinkle in her eye. I guess she's rediscovered his twinkle.
Now, just the other day, Cindy and I tracked down another member of that fabled Rat Pack, comedian Joey Bishop. He was down south making a movie with Alan Alda, but he took a break to talk with us in New York and Cindy in Los Angeles about his old buddy Dean.
Dean had a great, great sense of humor. In 1942, I got my first furlough. My wife took me to a nightclub. I saw a handsome guy coming down the steps. The music was Temptation. And they played in Bolero Temple. Boom, ba-da-da-dum, ba-da-da-dum. And you know what the first thing Dean sang coming down the steps? He sang, "Use came, I was alone, I should have known, use was temptation." I thought, this guy is brilliant.
Joey,
yes.
Did you guys really do all of that exciting sex and booze and broads, or was it ridiculously trumpeted?
Cindy, let me tell you something that may be a shock to you.
Yeah.
I have never had a drink of liquor in my life.
How about a woman?
And my wife. I'm married 48 years. Why would I tell you what I haven't told my wife?
But it seems that in those days, Sammy was doing a little bit of drugs, and Dean was doing some whiskey, and
right.
Sinatra was doing some women. What were you doing, keeping score?
No, I was announcing. I was announcing. I was telling the girls who were waiting for Frank, number 26, next. Now, let me tell you something you said about Dean drinking, right?
Yeah.
In the bottle of JB that he had on stage, my dear Cindy, was apple cider.
Is that right?
When I tell you something, you don't have to ask me, is that right? Otherwise, I wouldn't have said it.
What is it about Jeanne and Dean Martin?
I don't know, but if Dean married Jeanne tomorrow, I swear to God, I would pay for the wedding.
What is it about her that's so special?
A great woman, and he's a great guy. I don't know what happened in between.
When did you speak to her last?
1926, during a Dempsey-Tunney fight.
Joey, I think on that high note.
She said, "Who do you think will win?" And I said, "Don't bother me." And since then, she hasn't bothered me.
Joey Bishop, thank you so much.
Oh,
you're a delight.
I wish you both a very happy Thanksgiving.
You too, Joey. Quite a character. Now, Jay Bernstein, talking about characters, knows more Hollywood secrets than anyone, even some that our Cindy Adams doesn't know. The other day, he blew the whistle on some of Hollywood's hottest stars. And tonight, he has more untold stories. Something.